thinking about a credit card balance transfer. Hi, I'm Carrie Kakuta, the Someday Coach. There's the problems is what I'm going to be talking about today. If you're having problems with your credit card balance transfer, some of the things that you want to watch out for is that you need to pay them on time. If you default in them, then if you were given a special rate to get that balance transfer, you're going to be jumping up to their original rate and losing that introductory rate that they gave you for the time frame that they gave you, 6 months, 8 months, to a year. So you want to be careful and make sure you're paying them on time to take advantage of the introductory rate that you got from the transfer. As well as if you continually do them, you can do them once in a while and it won't affect your credit too much. But once you do too many of them, you're going to really see a drop in your credit. So be very careful. I would suggest to maybe do, you know, maybe you're be safe with one a year. So I would consider to do that. So use your best judgment when picking, as well as your transfer fees. A lot of people don't realize that it costs them money to transfer the fees. Read all the fine print. Typically, sometimes you'll see a 3%, you know, an average of 3% to 4% on a transfer fee. Now, that's how much you're going to pay just to move that money. So if you got $5,000 and you're going to move that money to another credit card, you're going to be paying $150 to do that. So you want to look for ones that have a cap rate. Sometimes you'll see a minimum on them that they've capped out. Maybe they say a minimum of $10 and their max is $50. So those are some of the problems or the things that you may find from a balance transfer that you want to keep in mind and make sure that you make an educated decision. Again, I'm Carrie. Thank you very much.